Did you know that the original Lorwyn lands formed two color panoramics for each one of the 10 color pairs? Dimir, Orzhov, Boros, Izzet, Selesnya, Simic, Golgari, Rakdos, Gruul, and Azorius? They just look amazing, don't they? Merch, like, comment, subscribe. Hello, welcome to Back to Basics, a show where I take EDH commanders and try to find the perfect basic lands to fit them. I love seeing someone sit down with some beautiful basic lands, but something I love even more is seeing how well those lands match their commanders. One quick note before we begin. I like to give the artists credit for their artworks, but I may not pronounce their names perfectly. I'll try my best, but please forgive me and correct me if that ever happens. First up, we've got Godo, Bandit Warlord, a wonderfully unique commander, in both in terms of its playstyle and its artwork. Its crisp linework and its almost comic book style is something almost no other artworks in MTG even have, much less commanders. So I landed on this mounted from Ice Age, illustrated by Tom Wanderstrand, which has these strong, illustrative lines that divide the objects from their backgrounds. Another potential candidate is this mounted from Odyssey, illustrated by Anthony S. Waters, that also has a strong linework frame that the image sits on. Plus, it also matches the darker hued tones of the rest of the artwork. But honestly, both are amazing and match very well with Godo's unique attributes. Next up, we've got Purphoros, God of the Forge, another mono-red commander. Now, there wasn't much that we needed to match with him, at least not for his standard framing, simply because there are so many different types of mountain that this can fit. But I settled for this mountain from Jumpstart because of how much it was emphasizing the eruption of the volcano and the smoke billowing from its peak. However, I liked this mountain as well from Commander 2016, illustrated by Kev Walker, that has lava flowing around a city, which lends itself thematically to the Theros aesthetic of gods living among the people. But for his alternate framing, this was a little bit trickier, because there was a heavy emphasis on his star orientation and patterning. The Theros Beyond Death lands were an initial go-to, but I wanted him to have something that was a little bit more specific and matching aesthetically. So I landed on this mountain from John Avon from Champions of Kamigawa. I felt like the purple and violet hues along with the white flecks of the snow coming in from the mountains serves to continue the beautiful patterning of the stars in Purphoros' constellation frame, and would look absolutely gorgeous in multiples. Next up, I've chosen a difficult one. It's Brea, Aetherium Shaper. Now this one is tough, because it is a four-color commander, so you'll need to have your lands match up with one another as well as your commander. But with Brea, there were some strong tie-ins. She comes from the shard of Alara called Esper, which focuses on white, blue, and black mana, with emphasis on order and artifice. So I started there, choosing this plains, this island, and this swamp, all illustrated by Chippy from Shards of Alara. The only issue that I had was that Brea has another basic land type to consider that is not in this set, and that is the mountain, or the red mana. In many ways, this throws us for a loop, because none of the red lands from the Plain of Alara really match her style. But I found that this mountain from Strixhaven gets close, with the rotation and the order among the natural structures being a theme that can fit across all of the artworks. That contrast fits well with her overall style. However, if you wanted to go a little bit differently, you could focus on the idea that Brea's art has the red hues being shown off as lightning bolts flying from her fingertips. So the idea came to try this mountain from Jumpstart, illustrated by Adam Paquette, to match the electricity and the geometric patterns emphasized by the other lands within its set. And finally, we have a personal favorite, Edgar Markov. Now this one can be remarkably simple, but expensive. Edgar is the quintessential vampire commander, and as such, the Dracula basics from the Dracula Secret Lair, like this mountain, illustrated by Grzegorz Ruchowski, and this swamp, illustrated by Jonas Durow, and this plains, illustrated by Donato Giancola, all fit the aesthetic seamlessly and beautifully. However, because these secret layers are expensive, we had to have a set that didn't require hundreds of dollars to complete. So take a look at this plains, illustrated by John Avon in M10, that matches the red tone of the commander, this swamp from Avacyn Restored, illustrated by Adam Paquette, and this gorgeous mountain, illustrated by Sam White. This places primary emphasis on the red color palette, while showing off that gorgeous blood moon that is central to a lot of vampire visual style. But there you have it. Five more commanders sorted for which basic lands I think match them best. But I want to see what you think. Tell me which commanders you'd like me to try and pick out basic lands for. Comment below and let me know, and have a great day.